Welcome everyone to AFSA, your home in the Foreign Service. We're so pleased to see so many old friends. And I'd like to start by thanking all of our scholarship donors, many of whom are here today, to our AFSA board members, AFSA committee members who are here with us today. So thank you, and a special thanks, and I want to give a big round of applause to Lori Deck, to Jonathan Crawford, and to our intern Karen. So thank you. Another special recognition, I believe he is here, to the winner of the Foreign Service Cup this year, Ambassador Richard Kosgorich. Yes. He is an outstanding, one of my former bosses, one of my mentors in the Foreign Service, so thank you, Richard. Now, the AFSA Scholarship Committee does a lot of hard work, and I want to also recognize all of the volunteer merit award judges who put in many hours to select our winners here who are here today. Some of them, can you raise your hands who are volunteer judges who are here? So thank you. And now, the reason we're here is to honor all of our high school award winners. These are our merit award winners. And this reception is a way to recognize all of the great work they have done as children of the Foreign Service. And one of them, I have to give special recognition, I'm sorry, a lot of self-pleading here, but Paul Rohrlich and his son Jordan, who worked with me in Embassy Tel Aviv. I know that Paul and Susan are here. Can you raise your hands? Congratulations. This is mostly a congratulations to the parents because you know, this helps them in their future financial endeavors. So I share your congratulations. And finally, a big thank you to all of the Foreign Service retirees who are here, because it's the retirees who are the major contributors to this program. So thank you for everything you do. So today we are celebrating the 39th year of this merit scholarship program, and we are recognizing 27 students out of over 100 applicants who will receive merit awards totaling $48,500 in prizes for their college education. You will find elsewhere on this floor outside this auditorium information on the award winners. There's also handouts for you to look at. And we'll shortly give our certificates to our award winners. But I also want to mention another program, which is our financial aid-based, needs-based scholarship program. And that is over $200,000 a year, thanks to our donors. And I want a special shout out and recognition to one of those donors who is here for our financial aid program. And that is Congressman Chris Van Hollen of the great state of Maryland. And I want to say, please stand up. Congressman Van Hollen and his family have just endowed last year a scholarship in memory of his parents, Christopher and Elisa Van Hollen Memorial Financial Aid Scholarship. They were in the Foreign Service, they were members of the Foreign Service, and Chris Van Hollen was a child of the Foreign Service. So we're very pleased to have him with us today. Now, we have nine named merit awards in the AFSA scholarship program, named for individual donors. And five of them are with us today. So it's my distinct pleasure to recognize them, and I'd like each of them to stand up, and at the end we'll have a round of applause for those five. First we have John and Priscilla Becker, who have established the perpetual Priscilla and John P. Becker Family Merit Scholarship in 2001. And next we have Ms. Julia Wright, representing the CareFirst Blue Cross Blue Shield Federal Employee Program. This is the second year that the Health, Vision, and Dental Insurance Company has sponsored two merit awards. And we have Lloyd Yavener, Vice President of the Embassy Risk Management Company. This is the first time. This overseas property insurance and auto insurance company is sponsoring an award for the first time. Then we have Miss Susie Taylor, the daughter of John C. and Nancy C. Leary. She has sponsored an award in the memory of Susie's mother, Nancy, who passed away in April 2013. And finally, we have Mrs. Maria Giuseppa Spiegler, who with her late husband established the perpetual Donald S. Spiegler Memorial and Maria Giuseppa Spiegler. So thank you to all of our donors, to all of our award winners, and to present the certificates, it's my honor to introduce Ambassador Lan Schemmerhorn, who is our chairperson for the awards committee, the scholarship committee, who does outstanding work, and is my collaborator in AFSA. So please, Ambassador.
Thank you, Bob. And welcome to everyone. It's a pleasure to see so many people here today as we honor these young people. And it's a particular pleasure to see Representative Van Hollen here. I've now served as AFSA Scholarship Committee Chair for 3 years. This is the third time I've had the privilege to be a judge. And I can attest to what a difficult task it is to assess and read the achievements of these outstanding young people that we have in our Foreign Service family. All the winners and judges' names can be found in this trifold brochure that you probably have seen around the world and can pick up a copy of. The winners and the Merit Award donors will be published in the July-August issue of the Foreign Service Journal and will also be posted on the scholarship page of AFSA's website. In a moment or two, we're going to dim the lights and share a brief slideshow of the 28 winners, after which we will confer the awards on the 6 local students who were able to be present today. How we go about judging them is as follows. We have 6 separate criteria, and you have to score well in all the categories to be named winners. Of the academic merit applicants, a Best Essay Award winner and a Community Service Award winner are also chosen. As for the Art Merit Award, applicants submitted their entries in one of the following categories: musical arts, visual arts, performing arts, or creative writing. So now I'm going to ask Jonathan to start the slideshow. But especially for their creativity in finding something new every year. Having the slideshow where you can see the photos of all the winners, even those who were not able to be present, is a new idea this year, and I think it's very nice. Now we're going to call each of the students to the podium alphabetically to receive your check and certificate, which the AFSA president will present. Thank you. again, the name scholarship recipients. Okay, the named scholarship recipients are the highest placing students in the competition. So I'm going to read the name and a little bit of bio background about them, and then they'll come up and Bob will give you the certificate. First to the podium is Grace Bachman. She's the daughter of Brian Bachman and Jan Fisher Bachman. She is the Embassy Risk Management Scholar. She's a student at Chantilly High School and plans to attend Endicott College in Massachusetts to study business. High School in Alexandria and plans to attend the University of Virginia to major in business. Next, Timothy Kostolanchik. He's the son of David and Patricia Kostolanchik. David is the State Department. Timothy is the Donald S. Spigler Memorial and Maria Giuseppe Spigler Scholar. Timothy is a student at Langley High School in McLean, and he plans to attend Oberlin College majoring in foreign languages. Next we have B. Phoenix Morrison, the son of Steve Morrison, who is AFSA's Commercial Service Vice President, and Carol Fishback. Phoenix is a student at St. Anselm's Abbey School in Washington, and he is the Priscilla and John Becker Family Scholar. He will attend Vassar College majoring in physics. Mr. Sullivan worked for the State Department, and Ellen was formerly with the State Department. Olivia attends Thomas Jefferson High School of Science and Technology in Alexandria, and she will attend St. Olaf's College in Minnesota to major in biology. Next, Maya Yu. She's the daughter of Sharon Yanagi and Alan Yu. Alan is with the State Department. Maya attends Georgetown Day School in Washington, and she will major in chemistry at UCLA. Now we have several students who are not with us today, but we want to acknowledge them here. We have the grandfather of Greer Christensen Gibbons here, I believe. Is that correct? He will come forward to receive the certificate from Greer. Greer and her family are in Berlin, but Richard Christensen, grandfather, will accept the award.
Congratulations.
Then we have Sarah Carlson, the daughter, she's the John C. and Nancy S. Leary Memorial Scholar. Susie Taylor, the daughter of Leary, and her sister, Barbara Leary Jones, and Barbara's husband, Doug, are all present, I believe. And if they will come forward, Mr. Zilker, you're not him, so, okay, no. I'm sorry, no certificate, but we want to acknowledge that you're here. Sarah can't be here because she's in Thailand, and she will attend the University of Virginia majoring in education. And then we have Morgan Pratt and Rebecca Sarfati. Both of them are the Care First Blue Cross Blue Shield Federal Employee Program Scholars. And this is the second year that this organization has supported two awards in the program. Morgan will attend the University of North Carolina Chapel Hill to major in math. He's currently in Wellington, New Zealand with his parents, Adrian and Margaret Pratt. Rebecca will attend Brown University and major in pre-law. Rebecca is also AFSA's Art Barrett winner for her creative writing short story and poem submission. Her parents are Linda Detweiler and Mark Sarfati, who are living in Seoul. And lastly, we want to acknowledge Joanna and Robert Martin, because they are Merit Award donors who are not with us today. They live in California. But they sponsor two awards to students who either apply and or attend one of their five alma maters. The recipients are Natalie Mango and Connor McKinney, who are not with us today. Natalie is in Vienna, and Connor is living with his family in Charleston, West Virginia. Mrs. Dorothy Cameron has established a merit award in her late husband's name, Turner Cameron Jr. The recipient of this award is Jackson Steger, and he is in Guatemala now. So this concludes the You've anticipated me. I was going to say this concludes the awards, and now let's give a round of applause. Over to Laurie Deck so she can coordinate the pictures of the winners and donors here. So if you'll allow that to happen, and then we can resume the reception. Thanks.
I just wanted to say again, thank you for coming. We're going to have some pictures up front. This reception runs until 5, so please enjoy yourself, and thank you again for coming. Appreciate it.